Hello guys, this is Ravens from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 158. Along with the Samsung Galaxy Watch and earbuds, Samsung also launched Galaxy Z Fold 3 and Z Flip 3 at the Unpacked event. These are the world's first foldable phones with an IPX8 rating for water resistant. Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3 and Galaxy Z Fold 3 will go on sale in India soon. If we talk about the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3, it comes with a 6.2-inch HD+ Dynamic AMOLED outer display. And it also comes with a 7.6-inch QXGA+ Dynamic AMOLED Infinity Flex display. It runs on Snapdragon triplet processor and it has a 12 megapixel triple rear camera. It will be coming with a 4400 mAh battery with a 25 watt fast charging support. If we talk about the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3, it comes with a 6.7 inch Full HD+ Dynamic AMOLED Infinity Flex display. It also has a 1.9 inch secondary AMOLED display. It runs on Snapdragon triplet processor. It also has a 12 megapixel dual camera. It will be coming with a 3300 mAh battery with a 15 watt fast charging support. The Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 is the first smartwatch to run on the new Wear OS platform. The Galaxy Watch 4 Classic model comes with a rotating bezel. Samsung Galaxy Buds 2 features active noise cancellation and a curved design. One of the India's oldest corporation is planning to enter one of its newest growth industry. The Tata Group is planning to enter the semiconductor manufacturing space, an industry that is expected to play a key role in the country's future plans. At the Tata Group, they are planning to getting into a new businesses like electronic manufacturing, 5G network equipment as well as semiconductors. And moreover, the government has been encouraging companies to build semiconductor fabrication plants in India. With Jeff Bezos and Richard Branson's recent suborbital space flights, the concept of space tourism has gripped the interest of the world. Now an Indian from the state of Kerala is said to potentially be the country's first space tourist. His name is Santosh George Kulangara, a solo traveler, entrepreneur and the founder of travel and exploration channel Safari TV. He was the first Indian to be selected for the paid space tourist by Branson Virgin Galactic in 2007. He is now a part-time member of the Kerala State Planning Board. As Kulangara gear ups for his space travel, Virgin Galactic is yet to confirm when he will embark on his journey and whether or not it will require more training on it. As per the Kulangara's website, they have confirmed the seat as passenger number 38. Vodafone Idea RedX plans are ₹1,699 and ₹2,299 family plans offers 3 and 5 member connection. The telecom network is offering 1-year Amazon Prime membership, Netflix subscription, Disney Plus Hotstar VIP and access to Vodafone Idea movies and TV VIP. Vodafone Idea has removed the ₹799 postpaid family plan. These two offers benefits like unlimited calls and unlimited data as well. There's a new RedX plan comes alongside with the ₹1,999 RedX postpaid plan that also brings unlimited calls and data to a single connection. Reserve Bank of India have recently introduced a scheme to impose penalty on banks if ATMs remain out of cash. If ATMs fails to dispense cash for more than 10 hours in a month, the bank will face a penalty of ₹10,000 per ATM. For white label ATMs failing to ensure the cash of ATMs, the penalty would be charged to the bank which is meeting the cash requirement of the particular operator. And the bank can later recover the penalty from the WLA operator. And this new rule will be effective from October onwards. The Drugs Controller General of India has given its approval for a study on mixing of Covaxin and Covishield COVID-19 vaccines in India. This study and its clinical trials will be conducted by Christian Medical College, Vellore. The purpose of this study is a group of vaccine recipients who were accidentally given doses of different COVID-19 vaccines in Uttar Pradesh earlier this year. Battlegrounds Mobile India Independence Day Mahotsav announced from August 11 to August 20. Krafton has announced various rewards during the event, including a time-limited AWM skin. This event will also have new missions every day with exciting rewards. Great news for all the Battle Royale game fans this week, as PUBG will be free to play the entire week. With unlimited access to every game mode, along with access to the game, players will also be able to retain their stats, pass and mission rewards alongside with XP and BP. PUBG has also planned special event to welcome new players to the PUBG, meaning there has to be several cool rewards for all the players. The game will be free to play on Steam and players have to create their own global account from accounts.pubg.com and link the account with their Steam account. By linking their global and Steam accounts, player will also earn special rewards such as traditional glasses. Reward distribution takes place every day at 10:30 PM Indian Standard Time. The free play schedule looks like this is for PUBG on Steam from August 9th 2:30 AM to the August 16th 2:30 PM. OnePlus Note 2 launched in India last month at a starting price of ₹27,999. On Twitter, a user claimed that a Note 2 unit got exploded. However, OnePlus, after investigation, found that the incident is no way involved any OnePlus product. MediaTek has announced two new Dimensity processors. The latest offering are the successor to last year's Dimensity 900 and Dimensity 800 processor. The new chipsets are expected to arrive in smartphones as early as Q3 2021. MediaTek Dimensity 920 and Dimensity 810 processor have been launched today. The new chipsets are based on 6-nanometer manufacturing process and are aimed at a mid-range smartphones. Realme India and Europe CEO Madhav Seth has confirmed the company will be the first to launch a phone powered by the new MediaTek Dimensity 810 chipset. This announcement comes after the MediaTek unveiled the Dimensity 810 and the Dimensity 920 5G chipset. Realme will be announcing the Realme Book on August 18th in China. On the same day, the company will be unleashing the Realme Book Slim in India. The Realme Book's live shot shows that it will arrive with an aluminium build. The lid of the device has a minimalistic look as it only features a plain Realme branding. The top bezel with the laptop features a webcam and other branding can also be seen on the bottom bezel. As per the images, you can also see a fingerprint sensor can be seen in the upper right corner above the backlit keyboard. Below the keyboard is a large trackpad which probably carries support for gestures. The device right edge has a pair of USB-C ports and there is a USB slot and a 3.5mm audio jack available on the left spine. A day-to-leap branding can also be seen on the underside. Xiaomi is set to launch a refreshed Mi notebook with a backlit keyboard. The upcoming offering is also expected to be powered by an upgraded 11th generation processor. This announcement comes ahead of the Realme Book Slim launch in India. However, Xiaomi is yet to officially announce the launch date of its next laptop. This year's iPhone are soon expected to make their official entry. The new iPhone 13 models will most likely come with a portrait video mode which will bring the bokeh effects to videos besides still photos. This feature is most likely to be called as cinematic video and will also let people change the level of background blur after the video is recorded. This is a feature that has made its way on many Android phones from OEMs such as Vivo, Oppo and many more. Another feature we might see is the new pro resolution video recording which will help people take high quality videos. This is a format used by professional videographers and will help content creators make use of future iPhones to make high quality videos. This will be in addition to the Pro RAW mode that was introduced on the iPhone 12 series for high quality photos. Reserve Bank of India have recently introduced a scheme to impose penalty on banks if ATMs remain out of cash. If ATMs fails to dispense cash for more than 10 hours in a month, the bank will face a penalty of Rs 10,000 per ATM. For white label ATMs failing to ensure the cash of ATMs, the penalty would be charged to the bank which is meeting the cash requirement of the particular operator. And the bank can later recover the penalty from the WLA operator. And this new rule will be effective from October onwards. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.